Do we have 7 setups? Okay, we have 6 because one of them was for Toho, right. Yeah, you should be good. Wait, twist it up. Yeah, maybe twist it a bit further towards you. Let's see. Twist it a bit toward. It needs to be a, you're like on the left, on the right side of it, so. There you go. Yep. Here we go with the first match of the night. We got KH Gamer versus Mole. Old and Mole. Going with the Joker. Interesting, we've got. Let's see how this works out then. And of course, KH Gamer with living up to the name with the Sora. Wouldn't have it any other way, folks. KH is off, naturally off to a very strong start here. Has almost double the percent on Mole that Mold has on him. That could have been a big punish, but KH Gamer getting the Nair loop into Nair combo into up air. And there's another Nair combo getting 30%. Not sure if it was all true, but still. Good way to start off the second stock. Can Mold answer back? He's got to be a lot more selective of his openings and needs to find more opportunities to punish KH Gamer's habits. And really needs to get the most out of this Arsene while he can. There's a nice counter. Not going to be taking stock of it, though. Ooh, dash attack. That's big. Forcing. Fortunately, not able to interrupt KH Gamer's recovery, but he gets caught by the last hit of the up tilt, and that is the second stock, first stock of off of KH Gamer. Mold still in a bad position here, though. It's the gap is definitely closed a bit. Nice stuff, KH Gamer, respecting the gun, just keeping his lead safe, not giving. Never mind. Gets him with the F tilt and then the side B, and the blade's building back up. What he really needs to do is try and not let Mold live for too much longer, because if he, or especially not be so predictable as to give him a Rebel's Guard, because it won't be long before another Arsene is here. He don't want to be dealing with a second Arsene for a stock. There it is. This is where it becomes... Ooh! That catches him with the Thundaga, stuffing out the second Arsene and maintaining his lead. Very good. Very good stuff. Ooh, trying to go for the style combos, but misses the execution. And there's the classic side B, forcing him into a more disadvantageous position, using the Makarkan to reflect the Thundaga. And speaking of which, the Arsene is online once again. This is a do-or-die situation for Mold. Missing the back air, doing it a bit too early to punish the get-up attack. And there it goes, 95%. Very unlikely he gets another this game. He's going to have to play it all the... Ooh, nice back air, catching him on the platform to take this second stock. Really wanting another Arsene. That Rebel's Guard, unfortunately, not able to find the hit to go and hide just high enough to get... Ooh, nice punish for keeping KH Gamer off stage, though he had a decent idea. Unfortunately, he was too slow, giving KH Gamer, and this is a big deal. Another Arsene. If he can't get a bunch out of this, I'll be very surprised. Once again, falling to victim to the Thundaga. Game one going to KH Gamer by a decent margin. Though Mold wasn't completely outclassed here, so I wouldn't put it past him to take a game. Maybe even the match if he can really get things figured out, though. KH Gamer is one of our better players. If it's not out of the question that he'll steamroll here. On to game two. No counterpicking going on here. Once again, KH Gamer off to a strong start, stuffing out the gun. Gutsy stuff for KH Gamer. That is not an easy move to challenge. There's a better gun that's still not going to do it. Just going for the Makar Karn to not take the Thundaga there. Missing a big punish opportunity on that side B. Good patience from Mold, not getting caught by the Thundaga. That's been the death of him for this. And once again, Mold is getting too desperate to find a counter. It's came back to bite him hard with that Arsene. That was a but gets answered with an up air to take the stock, and KH Gamer is in a prime position to sweep this game. Okay, there's something that you might want to try more. Getting the Devil's Guard on the Thundagas. Here it is. With this deficit, it's not the ideal time for Arsene, though if he can make it count, he can really even the game up on us on the spot. Mold just does not seem to have an answer to KH Gamer's pressure and gets the confirm into the up smash. Ouch! Two stock deficit. Yeah, that's a rough one. Yeah, Mold does not seem to know how to deal with KH Gamer's and Sora's pressure. Just getting caught by all the frame traps. Is about to get another Arsene, though I don't think that's going to be an... So that alone is not going to get him back in this game. And once again, not respecting the Thundaga. Right now, the question is Mold gonna get restocked here? And there's the, likely the final Arsengon gets back to the ledge just in time to avoid the Thundaga, and the hardest of reads running up to up smash him when he jumps. It's just a very savage move from KH Gamer to take the match in commanding fashion. Well, do remember, as the first match of the night, there's still... Neither is out. Mold is not out of the tournament yet, folks. He could make a spectacular loser's run. It's possible. Now, who are we going to be having on stream next? Oh, why am I on here twice? Also, respect on KH Gamer for taking the time to discuss Mold's mistakes with him. That is the height of respect you put. Some players just... Now who? Well, with that out of the way, we'll see who we have on next. Looks like our next match is Taminus versus Dark Sun. These two players definitely know each other well. The Kazuya versus our best Joker. Always a fun one to see. Wait, what? Taminus has a... Wait, or am I getting him confused? I am... No, that's Taminus, alright. I did not know he had a Robin. I mean, granted, he has played a lot of characters in the past, but... Still. A very odd character to see come out. We'll see if he can make it count. Make the... Robin do some work. Certainly off to a strong start here. Just needs one more good hit to end Dark Sun's stock for the... The big thing about Robin is that a lot of his game plan revolves around that. The Arc Fire and the Levin Sword, in the right hands, Ramen can get massive combos off of just one of those. Dark Sun really getting some nice lasers on Taminus's recovery. Trying to catch him jumping on the ledge, but does not early enough. Another grab to force Taminus back off stage. The stock gap is closing quick. Ooh, nice stuff. Keeping up the pressure with the arc fire on the platform. Just getting his forward smash, sending him off stage. His Dark Sun's percent is just building up. Going for the forward throw there. Oh no! Getting caught by the puppy meteor smash to take using his second stock at a very low percent. This is not what you want to see for Dark, as Dark Sun at least. Really just keeping up the, Temenos keeping up the pressure, trying to keep, make sure that Dark Sun has no chances to rest, and he's just got him on books, losing the Levin Sword at just the wrong time, and probably wasn't going to be taking the stock at that percentage. Yeah, it's, looks like he got it back though. If he can find, all he needs is one more, one good hard read for at this percent, so Dark Sun's going to have to be very careful. Right now is the question. Oh, that's my call, folks. I will be back later.
Kazuya. Three, two, one, go!
Thunder! Thunder!
Wins.
battle. battle.
Well, it seems like tonight is a situation tonight where the everything Murphy's Law is in full effect for the stream. Everything that can go wrong seems to be going wrong, so unfortunately I'll have to forgo the quadcast for now and just go back to the Mac AirBook microphone, so apologies for the dipping audio quality. We've got Sunny T and Meeks going back to their mains.
Where's the game from?
I think I just barely got here, so I don't know for sure.
But you just know Sunny's one more.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Something like that. Yep, sorry folks, I've really tried everything with the podcast, but it just refuses to work tonight. This is a pretty interesting situation. Ooh, does not respect the can well enough and gets caught by it for the stock. Mm-hmm. There is one last thing I could try to get the quadcast mic working again, but it would probably require me to reset the entire stream, and so hope the Mac Airbook mic is enough for tonight's. It's like we're going to game three, folks. This is a game where looks like Meeks is on the back foot. Sunny T is in a prime position to potentially win this game and match. He's not able to find the way around the frisbees right now. Does get an up B. It's not enough to kill at that percent. It does find the nair to close out the stock though. So it's not over yet, folks. Oof, not enough to a good start on this stock though. Still, the big problem for Duck Hunt is that that Duck Hunt does not have any great ways to finish off stocks. The deficit may not matter so long as Meeks can just stay alive and as a result stay in this game. He can just build up the percent slowly but surely. He'll be back in control in no time. And as predicted, it makes his close the gap. Sunny T is suddenly at the deficit. He needs unable to capitalize on that frisbee. That is unusual to see. He's even up the percents. This could come down to last hit, folks. That could be a problem for Sunny T because it is a lot easier for Samus. Oh, is this best of five?
This is best of three. Hasn't Sunny won two games?
No, I think this is the third game. Sunny T doing a good job maintaining control of the game right now. The fact remains, sooner or later, he's going to have to find the stock, and the longer it takes, and Meeks catches him going high with the charge shot to take the match. Admirable play from both players here, folks. Just
gave in. Yeah, crazy one. Yeah. Are they open? Are they open?
guy got out of the hole.
Yeah. just give it up. You know, if they wanted it, I'm just giving it up.
Is this what happened to your dad?
Why is my water getting
on the ground?
Put it on the ground?
Put it on the ground?
I put it next to a chair.
Yeah, well, who's looking down at it? It got kicked like 4 times.
Because bracket starts at 8.
Give me a right side.
2, 1, go!
Yeah, I got actually in the back of the train, they're like just off of other controllers.
I went to Justice Dragon's class the other day playing with him. I'm like, can I possibly borrow a CRT just for like a week, you know, just to play a little bit? I just have one. He opened up these doors.
Yeah. We never have equipment.
He does everything.
It's so nice to have that player, like, honestly.
Yeah, it's nice. I just came here and got my nice controller.
Yeah, I got the drop off at all the
time. I like the idea more of a
Yeah. It's just a run through. It's it just really nice. That's the thing, it does seem proportional to like how much bullshit is on adding the controller is like how bad it is.
Yeah.
Like you really need like a couple mods that are good. Maybe not good if you're like an Austin. And then like that's it. But like my controller, like I got the paracord is a nice one. Because like I don't have to constantly worry about bending it and shit. Like this is like a nice clean, simple controller.
already.
Shine grab and jump cancel grab are really hard. If you have to either do Z to X, which is a weird motion you're used to on white as leads, or for jump grab, and shine grab like this.
That's an easy one.
Hey, I need that was better. All the string, please. Thank you.
I'm gonna.
No, he's like,
oh, yeah, I hope you're in a minute.
controller. When will a Melee player ever be fine with a controller?
I've never once. I have a Boomwave. I have a Foe, Fox. I hate all my controllers. You'll never find a stick that works, because after 2 weeks it won't feel that way anyway. Even if you find it, it'll last a few weeks. Yeah, no, I've heard of them. Yeah. That's crazy. To me, that makes sense. Well, I mean, that's